Jose, how many punches do you throw in a round? Do you happen to know?
I don't know, man. I would have been in a fight?
No, in a gym.
No,
like on a bag or...
I wouldn't know. But in this gym, man, we're all pretty active. I think the style that you develop here in this gym is to be active, you know?
It's a lot of good action.
Yeah. Did you enjoy the fights?
I did. Boxing's back now. Boxing's more popular than it's ever been.
Yeah.
It was a good crowd. It's good.
It's good to see though. It's good to see that fans are like supporting fighters. You know, it's a better way now. In a few years,
it's true.
You don't see too much the negativity from fans or fighters, no?
By the way, do you ever count how many punches he throws in a round?
No, we don't count punches.
Because Thurman posted yesterday that he threw 230 punches in one round. Is that a lot, 230, or is that?
Way too much.
Why too much?
That's a lot. Yeah.
From 180 seconds, that's more than a punch a second.
It's too much.
You think it's too much?
Is that more than Soto Carras threw in that fight that he broke the record?
I don't know. What did he?
I thought he threw 1,000 against Orozco.
Yeah. Yevgeny Gradovic threw 100.
He's 1,100. I threw 1,100.
In one round?
No.
No fight.
The total fight.
How many rounds?
It's also like 90% power punches too.
Yeah.
That's a lot of punches.
How many did Orozco? Soto Carras and the other guy. What's his name? The white boy, the rooster. They broke the record. What's his name? They threw like each like 2,000.
That's too many punches.
And a 10-rounder.
Too much.
And a 10-rounder.
It's not just the number of punches. It's how much quality are in those punches.
Accuracy.
I seen the fight. Obviously, it was on TV. But there was so many rounds where the rooster just had Soto Carras in one corner in the whole round and doing this.
Yeah. That
so they counted it, but was
but it doesn't
really
count.
And the Thurman, did he do it during sparring?
Yeah, sparring.
Did he do 236 rounds?
On a bag, I don't know. On the mitts, or maybe doubling bag.
That was sparring.
Maybe, no, not sparring.
I'm 50 years old, I can do that on a bag.
Yeah.
You know?
I don't know, he threw too many punches against Josito Lopez.
Josito told me what you just said. He just watched that fight once.
Huh?
I asked him, how many times did you watch your Thurman fight? Just once. He doesn't, it's over. What is he gonna do? But he looks in shape. He looks skinny.
Yeah, he's getting
it. It's good. So Caballo's getting married? It's exciting.
Married.
He looked good in his fight. That was a good fight. What did you tell him in the corner to motivate him, Robert?
There was a couple rounds where he...
He took it easy.
There was a couple rounds where... I thought he was too didn't do much, and those are probably the couple rounds that he lost. He was just there blocking, and I told him, look, I don't look. This guy's not hurting you, and this guy is not gonna beat you. That's why you're too comfortable just blocking, because you're not a finishing punch. But you let him score, and the round was his because he threw more than you, and you just focus on blocking. He said, "Yeah, he's not hurting me. That's why he's not hurting. That's why you too. You're not even trying because you don't feel his power. But he did win the round. So if you continue doing that, he's gonna, the rounds are gonna accumulate, and then you're gonna have to knock him out to win." So he listened, there was two or three times that he did that, and I told him. And then towards the end, the last few rounds, I told him, look, for this guy, going the distance with you is already a win.
That's true.
Because everybody thinks you're gonna knock him out, or you're supposed to knock him out because of your power. So for him, just going the distance is already a win. So I told him, just pressure, push it, try, he's there, he's not hurting you, he's, go ahead. He did in the last round, almost knocked him out.
He almost.
But I think he needed those rounds too. Especially before a world title fight, I think that
was...
Is
he fighting for a title now?
Well, that was a title eliminator, so...
So who has the belt?
Munguia.
Wow, that's a big, that's a big one, Jose. Caballo Munguia?
Well, I'm Golden Boy, DAZN, so I'm not saying it's gonna happen.
he's top rank.
But he was, it was a tough eliminator. So I don't know, I don't know what the case is going to be there. But they are, you know, he is mandatory now. I'm not saying his next fight is for the title. He might fight one or two more. But that was a tough eliminator.
That's sick.
It was a tough eliminator.
Munguia is a great kid and a great fighter, but hasn't looked his best lately. We've seen him look better. So, but what happens if Munguia comes to you and wants to train here?
Well, then I can't anymore. Because we might fight him. That should have happened two fights ago.
Yeah?